Barber-Starkey is one of Canada's most successful and experienced business coaches. He's been coaching business owners full-time for over 20 years and was awarded the rare designation of Master Certified Coach by the International Coach Federation in 1999. Andrew has been the business coach for numerous rapid growth entrepreneurs, including Richard Jaffrey, president of Cactus Club Restaurants, and multi-millionaire T. Harv Eker, whose books, Secret of the Millionaire Mind, recently reached number one on the New York Times bestseller list. However, Andrew's real passion and skill is coaching self-employed business owners and independent sales professionals to achieve their business goals faster while improving the quality of their lives. Fellow Vancouver Business Network members and many most welcome guests, I invite you to put your hands together and give Andrew Barber-Starkey the welcome of his life!
Good work. Thank you. So, when Roger asked me if I would speak to this group, I've spoken to your group two or three times before at least. We've had some adventures, as a matter of fact, right? But I thought, you know, rather than just coming in talking at you, it's about time that I made you do some work. So tonight, instead of giving you a presentation, we're going to go through a workshop. And you're going to leave tonight having created for yourself an actual step-by-step process for creating a goal that is very, very important to you. Now, and by the way, that goal will be up to you, not me. there's good news and bad news. So the good news is that I'm not going to drone on and on. The bad news is you're going to do some work, and there's a lot to cover. We may not even finish it. But if we keep moving, we're gonna give it our best shot, and you're gonna get some fantastic value, and I'll set you up at the very least so you can go out and implement it going forward. So let me just tell you why this topic is current for me. First of all, I'm well aware, let me just check with you. I believe that most people don't achieve their goals. How many of you would say that the vast, vast majority of people don't achieve their goals? Do you agree with that? I mean, I've been only coaching for 23 years, and it's just so rare for people to set a goal and achieve it. Everybody who comes to me has a goal, and yet it never seems to come to fruition. So how and why, and what can we do about it? And so I'm always fascinated by that, in particular because I have a coaching program. Been now presenting this group, a group coaching program for small business owners, people who are paid based on performance. And I've been doing this now for 16 years, and in that time, we've had some unbelievable results. I mean, over 5,000 people have used the program. I don't know, 20, 30, 50, maybe even 100 millionaires have come out of it for sure that I know of. Some, you know, multi-millionaires have come out of it. And yet, in spite of that, I'm always looking for a way to make it better. And I've noticed that our members, it's kind of like the tortoise and the hare. They're tortoising along, they're consistently growing their businesses, but they're not really, really rocketing ahead as fast as they wanted to. And so that's where I started looking at my business model, my program, and saying, as good as it is and consistent as it is, and I would put it up against any other coaching program in the world, no matter what the cost, and our cost is pretty small, but even so, I see an opportunity for improvement. So let me just check with you. How many... Well, just bring to your mind a time when you have achieved something like really amazing. You got something in mind? Everybody brings something to mind. And a time when you were focused, a time when you were highly productive, a time when you're really energized. And I want to ask you a question. Everybody got a time in mind? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, good. How specific was your goal? Was it because it was just a general, it would be nice to get this, or was it a very specific outcome? Raise your hand for a very specific outcome? Yeah, almost every case, right? Was it something that it could sort of happen whenever, or did you perform better when there was a deadline?
Deadline.
Edmond, I know. When I was working in business partnership with Harv Ecker back in 2004, and I decided to end our business partnership, and I said, that's it, I'm done. And I created the program for him, and then within a couple of months, all these people started phoning me and saying, Andrew, Harv's doing a crappy job, we want to come back, we want you to be our coach. And I didn't have a program or anything, and I made the decision in January 2006, that I would create my own program. And I knew, absolutely knew, just on the basis of the way it's going to go, that program had to be launched in the end of March, or it just wasn't going to get off the ground, just in timing everything to fit with the opportunity I had with Harv, basically to take his clients. And so what did I do? I incorporated my company, I set up my bank accounts, I installed the computer network, I got the database set up, the accounting all set up, I designed a program, got it printed, got to create up a website, got the email marketing set up. I mean, all of that stuff in 2.5 months by myself with one part-time assistant. If I wouldn't have had the deadline, do you think that ever would have happened? No way, right? So there's something about the power of having a specific deadline that you're working to, and one very, very clear goal. And it's a huge difference between that and just going after general progress. Although, as I said, our clients have been very successful at that. So when you set a very specific goal, there's a number of benefits. I'm going to run through them quickly so we can get on to the workshop part, because I want to make sure you get your value. But let's, for one thing, when you have a very specific goal and time deadline, you focus, yes? Everything else falls by the wayside, right? You're zeroed in on it. Secondly, you're energized, yes? You're inspired, you're doing something, you're making something happen. And you become more creative. You start finding solutions and coming up with ideas and ways of doing things that you never would have thought of before. I also think that when you have a goal like that and you're focused on it, you're much more likely to collaborate and work well with other people, because the job has to get done, right? I remember one time, crazy, crazy story, but I ended up, I didn't know anything about advertising. We were selling advertising for a magazine, and suddenly the magazine, the person who was putting the magazine together, got sick. And I ended up putting this whole magazine together, and boy, did I collaborate. I didn't know a thing. And we got the whole thing to print, it turned out brilliantly well, and it was all because of my collaboration, which isn't typically my style, let's say, to be a working team. Another benefit is that when you've got that deadline and that very specific goal, you're much more determined. And mostly, biggest thing of all, you don't mess around procrastinating and thinking about when you're gonna do it. When do you do things? Now! Because there's more and more and more, you gotta keep going, right? So there's a lot of benefits to this specific goal. And that was the kind of tension I was thinking about that I wanted to create for our members, in addition to this consistent progress and growth that they were experiencing. So this summer, probably about July, I started thinking about that. And you know how the universe works, right? I come back from holidays in August, and somebody says to me, Andrew, have you seen this piece of work from Philip in Serbia, this stuff on goal setting? And I said, who's Philip in Serbia, and what's this goal setting thing about? So anyway, I got introduced to this guy, and I first of all bought some material off him online and took a look at what he had to say, and then I took a recorded webinar from him. And what I knew right away, as soon as I started looking at his material, is unlike everybody I've ever seen who's teaching goal setting, and I've been collecting goal setting stuff for 30 years. I got a box, I'll bet you 50 pounds, of goal setting material. And none of it is the right thing. This guy has got it. He knows what the obstacle is that prevents us from achieving our goals, why we don't, and how to go about doing it. Is that cool or what? Yeah. I thought the guy is just an absolute genius. It's just a revolutionary approach. And so, like I said, tonight, rather than teach it to you verbally, we're going to put you through the process, and you're going to get set up for it. Now, to be honest, I can only give you probably 20%, not even that, tonight. He's training me now to do a full-day workshop. As soon as I looked at the stuff, by the way, I just went, you're my coach, and I hired him. He's in Serbia. We do all our coaching sessions by Skype from 9-hour time difference. But if we can just get across to you tonight the process, then you'll be able to carry on it on your own and get some much, much better results with your goals than you do now. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So that's what we're up to. So this fellow Philip, like I said, he's a genius. And the first thing he says is that we don't really have a good picture of how we are in relationship to our goals. He says, for example, let's say we've got a pot of gold over here that we want. This will be you standing over here. How's that look? And you've got your eye on this pot of gold. That's what you want. And there's some things that are pulling you towards it, yes? So what do you want that this completing this goal is going to give you? Tell me.
Freedom.
Freedom, for sure. Freedom, yeah. What else?
Maybe revenue.
Revenue for what? What purpose? Freedom and
guitar.
Yeah, lifestyle. Okay, good. What else do you want to have this for?
Feeling of peace.
Feeling of peace, for sure, yeah.
Safety net,
security. Anybody want to impress people?
Oh, yeah.
Sure, of course, right? We got all these reasons, these pulls that are pulling us towards what we want. But what he says is, and this is the crucial piece, this is where most people just simply don't get it, and because it's so subtle. But he says, have you ever noticed that there are some things that are pushing you away from it as well? And by the way, there must be, because if not, you'd have it, right? So what's blocking you? Well, what are some of the things that could be pulling you away from that? Saying the negatives of potentially having that or doing the work to get it.
Rich people are evil.
Okay, so we have some context around rich people are evil, and we don't want to be evil. Okay, what else?
Afraid of success.
Fear of success, which might be a fear of failure, because if you become successful, you might fail.
Yeah,
right?
And also you think, well, it happens to others, not.
Yes. So I can't have it.
Yeah.
Or fear of overwhelm. If I get successful, I will manage.
Yeah.
The success.
So, anything else? Fear of, how about having to work too hard or getting trapped? Yeah.
Right. That's what I think.
Or having to apply or hire employees and get or rent a space or whatever and getting trapped. So we've got all these negatives. So here's what Philip says: is that with every goal that you have for yourself, you have to look at what is your orientation? And basically, your orientation is the net result of these pulls and pushes. Are you oriented towards your goal? In other words, you're moving towards it, or are you more oriented away from it? And I can tell you that for any goal that you have that you're not achieving now, you're oriented away from it, or you would already have it. Right? So, When he started talking about this, I realized it's just so true. Because there's something when you're, if you think of something that you're oriented towards that you're going to get, even though there's a lot of obstacles. Can you kind of get in touch with something like that? Even a silly thing for me, like my fitness is, it's just something I keep up. It's just part of who I am. I can wake up at 5:30 on a rainy, dark morning, we've had a few of those lately, and I look at the clock and it's 5:30, 25 to 6, and I go, okay, I'm going to the gym. I'm oriented towards going to the gym. I don't like going to the gym, I don't want to get up, I don't want to take the dog out in the rain before I go to the gym, any of that, but I do it because I'm oriented towards my fitness. It's just a natural part of me. And then there's other things that are almost effortless for me, to pick up and phone somebody and ask them for a referral or introduce myself to them, which is like just a little tiny thing, but I'm oriented away from it, and somehow or other, it just never happens. You got me? So what he says is that there's two reasons in his world that we don't achieve our goals. Number one is because we're not oriented towards them, we're oriented away from them. Does this make sense? And the second, which we'll get to in a little bit, is because we don't actually know exactly what we need to do to achieve it. We have the goal that what we want, but we don't know, what has to happen to make us get there. So we'll get that. So how many of you have heard that you have to have a burning desire in order to achieve your goal? Yes? Well, you know what Philip says? No, you don't. All you've got to do is remove all these negative charges and obstacles and resistances, and even if you just want something gently, you can go and get it if you pass the resistance. The reason that you need burning desire now is because of all these things you're trying to pull past them, right? Which is why, by the way, you know, I call it, and it's never intended to be offensive anyway, but I call it the immigrant mentality, where, you know, people will move to Canada and they'll do whatever it takes to, you know, they'll work 3 or 4 jobs and they'll work for, you know, minimum wage or whatever. They don't care. They're going to get, they're oriented to being successful in Canada no matter what. And we live in this world of complacency, of, you know, we've already got enough, we're in a comfort zone already. And so we don't have that burning desire. Which is why I was so excited when I heard Philip say, you don't have to have a burning desire if we can get rid of all this stuff, and then you just want a goal, you can go and get it. How cool is that? So that's the opportunity to learn this methodology and to be able to apply it in that way. And by the way, it was when he said, you don't have to have a burning desire to achieve your goal, that I went, you're my coach. And I got a hold of him in Serbia and hired him. So, you ready to do some work?
Yes.
Okay, we gotta watch our time here, let's get going. Everybody's got one? Okay. So we're, like I said, you're going to be doing the work here, and we're going to start with having you identify and set a goal for yourself. So a couple of criteria on this. First of all, I want you to set a goal for yourself that you is to be achieved within between 3 and 6 months. Now, you know, this goal setting process, I asked him the other day, well, what's the ideal time frame? And he says, well, anything, some people want to achieve a goal in the next week to get something done. Sometimes it's 5 years. But what I found is that as my clients, and I've been now working with my clients a bit on this and working it out myself, that between 3 to 6 months is a really good time frame to get a handle on the process. And then you can use it any way you want. So set yourself a goal. Think of a goal you want to achieve in the next 3 to 6 months. And I also want you to pick a goal that's not impossibly hard, but not effortless either. I want it to be strong enough that when you achieve it, you go, damn, that really worked. Not just, oh yeah, I knew I could get it. But don't do it, make it impossible. Again, you can use it on a very, very, very difficult goal once you've mastered the process, okay? So choose a goal for yourself. And I also would like you, ideally, to choose a goal that you wouldn't mind sharing publicly here, so we can get some share, all right? So again, you can do whatever you want. This is yours to take home. You can apply the process over and over again in different ways. I'd recommend you only work on one goal at a time, and we're just gonna start with this one for a practice, kind of the workout. Yes?
Yes?
All good? Okay. So just take a moment and write down your goal. Make it a specific, measurable, within your control. Can't have a goal for somebody else to marry you or whatever. So specific, measurable, and within your control. And then underneath is part two, additional characteristics. I'll give you an example. So when I started working with Philip, I set a income goal, a goal for myself to earn within 6 months to a certain level of increase in my income. And he said, well, are there any additional characteristics? I said, well, I don't want to be traveling all over Hell's Half Acre, that's for sure. I want to be at home with my family. I don't want to be working more than 40 hours a week. I want to be doing work that I'm good at and that I love, not just any old work that pays a bunch more money. So there's some additional criteria I had that I put on my goal to make sure I was clear about it. Does that make sense? So set a goal, write some additional characteristics if you can think of some, set a specific date by which you want to complete it, and then we'll get to the question 4. And if you have any questions at any time when you're processing, just raise your hand. I'll be happy to come around and help you. But my point here is that it's not, it doesn't have to be the perfect goal because you're just learning a technique. Goals can be business related, they can be personal, health, lifestyle, anything. Stay with me on this. There's some criteria as we move on. Does everybody have a feel complete with their, you're all good? Anybody need more time? Excellent. Okay, good. So now, just go to question four. It says, rate the difficulty of this goal on a scale of 1 to 10. So think about your current situation and resources. How difficult is it for you to accomplish this goal? Now, in this situation, I want you to be absolutely honest with yourself, because the truth is, if it was a 9 or a 10, in other words, it would be easy, you'd already have it, right? There must be some challenge in it or some obstacle for you to you having it, or you would have made it, you would have already achieved it. So give yourself a rating on a scale of 1 to 10 of how hard it is, and then for those of you that are my get-ahead people, let's go to page 2.
Is 10 very difficult?
10 is very difficult, is almost impossible. And again, you want to set something ideally would be a 5 to 8, right? Something that's not too easy and not too hard. Okay. Any questions or comments on that? We're all good? Excellent. Okay, good. Now, page 2. Let's take a look at how likely you are to achieve this goal. So we start by just assessing your own personal state. You know, where are you at right now? And with the, in relationship to this goal. And in a way, some ways, what's your orientation towards this goal? So it starts with, I'm completely determined to achieve this goal by the deadline date you set for yourself. Now again, if you're completely determined to achieve it, you probably would already have it, right? The chances are that most of the goals that you would set for yourself, if you were 100% completely determined to achieve them, you'd have them, yes? Yeah. So let's just take it for granted that you're not a 10, or you know, out of 10, you wouldn't be there. So, or else you'd already have it. So give yourself a rating in terms of how determined you are to have it. Achieving this goal is quite natural for me. That means, you know, if it's a 10 would be, it's a no-brainer, I could just reach out and do it. Yeah, not likely, or you probably would already have it. There's some difficulty involved with this.
But, question.
Yes.
Like how motivated I am at this minute, or how motivated I should be?
How, it's not about motivated, it's about how natural it is, how easy and effortless. It's just something I can easily do,
okay.
Right? Like if I said to you, you know, go and buy a sandwich, you can just go and buy it. It's a natural thing that you know how to do. If I said, go and rent me an import car for the day, you go, how do I do that, right? It's not so obvious to you, you have to figure it out.
So 10 is difficult.
A 10, achievement of the goal is it's quite natural for me is a 10, it's effortless. And a 1 is not so easy for me, right? I'm completely optimistic about achieving this goal. So again, be really honest with yourself. This goal that I set, how do I really, really believe it's gonna come true? I can make it, I'm optimistic, yes, I can have this. Okay, good, give it a rating, 1 to 10. I'm full of enthusiasm for it. I really, really want this. I'm excited about it, in other words. I know most exactly what actions I must take by in the next month to attain it. I know how to do it. And I'm in action. I promptly do whatever's necessary to achieve my goal once I've set it. It's boom, 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 you're in action. Questions on that? All good? And the next one, negative personality traits. These are about your resistances and these obstacles that we're pushing against here, right? So we want you to just think back on your own experience of achieving goals similar to this, or even maybe even set this goal for yourself before. Why didn't you achieve it? What was it about you that prevented you? Maybe you're not, you don't have a lot of self-control, or you procrastinate. Maybe you're just afraid of change. Maybe you're lazy, in your view. Maybe you just don't really want to do what it takes. So if you just get two or three items down there that are the biggest blockages, that would be useful. We're all good with that? Anybody need more time?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
More time.
Yeah, another minute?
We're getting it at the blocks.
Just identifying the blocks.
Procrastinating.
Procrastinating would be one.
No, doing it right
now. Oh, you're putting off doing it? Okay, got it.
Yeah, we need more time.
Does anybody else procrastinate? Okay, good. Anybody else going to raise your hand later?
Yes.
Yeah. Procrastinating, I'm putting up your hand. So again, if you just get two or three in that, the big ones, the ones that you see, you know, not being organized or not being motivated, not, you know, being satisfied with what you've got. Being lazy, not working hard, not focusing. I'm just trying to keep you moving here into the juicy part.
You want us to rate these?
Yeah. Once you've written them down, then list your strongest negative traits below. Rate each one on a scale of 1 to 10, according to the degree to which it limits your success. So a 1 would not limit you, be limiting your success. A 10 would be a total block. It's stopping you from doing what you need to do. Roger, this is so much easier than speaking. They're doing all the work. I'm liking this. How are you doing there, Lynn? You got enough time now?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
I'm just finishing the rating.
Yeah, so now give yourself a final rating, and I want you to be really critical, almost cynical on this. Pretend you don't even know this you. As an outside third party looking at this loser who's writing this stuff down and saying they're going to do it, how would, like, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much money would you bet on them getting it done? You'd, like, drop your whole paycheck onto it, or not so much? So give yourself a final rating on it. Everybody done that? So let's see. Raise your hand if you gave yourself a 80% or higher chance of succeeding. Good, must have set yourself an easy goal.
Not really. I put
7.5. 7.5, okay, good. Raise your hand if you were in the 50 to 75% range. Oh, bunch of optimists. You've said this goal a million times before and never achieved it. What's different now? Or is, you'd really trust me that much? Raise your hand if you did 25 to 50%. I think you guys are way more honest. Anybody less than 25%? What'd you give yourself?
20.
Yeah, that was me too. That was that, I did it with Philip, I'm going to give myself a 20%. Easy thing, I know how to do it, but was I going to do it? I don't know. What rating did you give yourself?
15.
Perfect. Excellent. Okay. So this is our setup. This is how we're going to, where we begin. Now, changing this around and basically getting rid of some of these blocks. So, next page. The goal achievement experience. Now, I want you to listen carefully to this. Goal achievement experience is a single paragraph that describes an imaginary future event in which your goal is fully achieved. In order to make it a complete experience, it must have a specific event, a place, a time, some emotions you're experiencing, and specific people that are involved, participants. So I want you to do this very quickly, just in the interest of time. I want you to write a bad paragraph. Don't try and get it right. But a paragraph, it's going to start with whatever you have a time frame for your goal, right? So it's going to start with Today is, and you've got to put some date that's after the completion date of your goal. So for me, today is April 1st, 2017.
April Fool's.
There you go, that's right. And this one isn't mine, this is one I got from his book, but imagine, I come home from work, my heart jumps for joy as my daughter runs out of my house and hugs me. That could happen in my house. I've arrived in our new car, which was recently purchased with cash. That could happen too. I have a surprise to give my wife, tickets to Hawaii for the spring break. We can easily afford it because I've more than doubled my income in the past 6 months. So we've got people, we've got a specific time, events that are happening, a place, okay? I feel calm and confident about my work, so I've got an emotional feeling. My new marketing plan is working perfectly, and I know for sure that my income is going to continue to grow. So time, place, emotions, participants. And again, just write a very quick paragraph on this. You'll be able to add to it and rewrite it when you go home, that's totally fine. But let's get something down for now, and then we're going to get into the real valuable part here. You get to improve it later. Good, good. Excellent. Great. They create a bad one, huh? No. One more minute. Okay, finish it up, whatever you've got there. And now we get to the best part of the evening. Find yourself a partner. Stand up and raise your hand if you do not have someone to partner with. Have you got a partner there, right here? Raise your hand if you do not have a partner. Can you work here?
I don't have a partner. Sure.
And I'd like you to share, just read your what you wrote for your paragraph.
Thank you.
Don't talk about it, just read it and then turn to the other person. The other person, it can be improved, we already know that. One person reads, then the other. Finish up and thank your partner, please. Again, Pam? Okay, that group of three is finished. You must be finished. All right? Okay, any questions or comments on it? I've asked you to create an experience which is very different than a single, you know, a single one-liner, right? It's much easier to get pulled towards an experience than it is to just a number or an event. Does that make sense?
Yes.
So that's the first thing we do that starts to diminish the sum of the negatives and sort of give you more positive. All right? So any questions on that or comments? Anything you want to say? Yeah, Lynn.
Yeah, I think this is so important because if I can't feel the excitement and the vibrancy and the compellingness of this, I'm not going to move more powerfully towards it.
Right. So now you've got this compelling, this piece that you're emotionally engaged in. And now we're going to get into more, how do you go about creating that? How many of you think that with your goal, or let's sort of do that assessment, one or the other, how many of you are absolutely crystal clear, you know what you need to do to achieve it, you just haven't been doing it up to this point? Okay, good, so about half, a little more than half. How many of you don't really know everything you need to do to achieve your goal? Yeah, about half and half. Okay, good. So there'll be different ways this unfolds for you. But I want you to turn the page now to page 4, is it? And where it says timeline of outcomes. And now what we're going to, this is a very interesting thing. Instead of standing here where you are today and projecting forward onto how this is going to happen, what we're going to do is have you transport yourself completely forward to the completion, the achievement of that goal. You're basically what we call your goal achievement experience, the time that the goal is completed. And I want you to imagine yourself actually being there. You've actually just completed this. So take yourself to that place. Okay? This paragraph you've written has just become true by the deadline that you set for yourself. And now I want you to imagine that you're looking backwards from that date, whatever date that is, towards November 15th, 2016, when you wrote this goal. And it's one of the ways it's helpful, I think somebody to work with me. Lynn, would you be willing to share your goals you've experienced? I want to hear it before I decide whether I want to work with you. If you could just read it for me, it would be great.
Oh, okay. Do you want me to just read it?
Yeah, just for to start with, yeah.
Okay. So today is June 1st. I love checking my ventures email and hearing how much people love the product we've launched and the connections they're making. I receive speaking requests because of this and have a full calendar ahead. Paul works with me and I love making money this way and expanding our ideas and reaching around the globe. The product is translated into French, Spanish, and Japanese. People submit ideas on a regular basis for one of the features called One Plus and love sharing other people's successes. We plan a holiday to celebrate.
Nice. Okay, good. Give her a hand. Thank you. Now, by way of opportunity for improvement, mm-hmm. Anybody, any observations? What did you notice that worked or didn't work about it? Anybody? Any comment?
Everybody. So I have specifics on the numbers on the previous page. I don't know if I should have put
yes, so I would like the specifics. So basically what happens when you write your initial goal,
okay,
and then you write your goal achievement experience, we just forget about your initial goal. We never look at it again. All we look at is the goal achievement experience. So the goal achievement experience needs to capture fully the numbers and every the specificity that is in your original goal.
Okay.
Not to worry. Is there somebody else who'd be willing to read theirs? That would be willing also to work with me? Yeah.
This is December of 2017. I am on vacation with my spouse. No worries of cash because even when I'm on vacation, I'm getting my income. I have purchased a brand new car and paid off my mortgage of my home. I have $600,000 cash sitting in my bank account and another $800,000 in the investments.
Okay, so you're it's an income, basically, or a financial goal you have for yourself, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I like the specificity you have in it, for sure. Now, is that, what did you give yourself in a rating of doability on that?
60%.
So you have a 60% chance. Historically, have you created that kind of income in that period of time?
Yes.
Okay, good. So let's, I'm looking for something a little shorter time-wise. Let's hear yours, and I'll pick one of the three. By the way, give them a hand. They're all good. I'm just looking for one that's going to great the right example I'm looking for. Catherine.
Today is December 24th, 2016. I smile broadly at the H&R Block agent as she hands me my completed tax folder. I think of the drawer in the storage locker with the neat tax files arranged by date. My living room is clear of tax clutter, and I have a new scanner that has sucked up all of my files and organized them digitally. I know exactly what to do for January 2017. I have a template for Evernote notebooks I'll need for the new year laid out already.
Okay, so quite a short-term goal for yourself. Now, which one's, what was your deadline on yours, Lynn?
June 1st.
Okay, listen, I'm gonna go with yours, okay? Give her a hand, by the way, Catherine, that's you. So basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna be standing in June 1st and looking backwards. Okay, so and you want to be drawing. So we're going to draw some lines. So we're going to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. So now here we are. It's June, right?
Yeah.
2017. So then before that we had May, we had April, we had March, we had February, we had January, we had December, and we had November. Right. So here we are standing here. As you look backwards from standing in this place that you wrote about there, what's some of the outcomes? A result that occurred that caused you to be able to achieve that goal? It was a significant milestone along the way. And when did it occur? Before the some of the steps that happened along the way, but we're working backwards this way. Now, here's the thing. This is a crucial piece. You're making it up. This isn't a plan, okay? We're not figuring out exactly how it happened. Is we just make up some shit that happened. It's very cool, right? So what's one of the things that happened in these months, March, April, May, June, that was a win for you, an outcome? Make it up.
The five major countries that are going to distribute the information on this product have all reached their goals in terms of number of people involved.
Okay, so when did that happen? Make up a date.
Say March.
Okay, good. So the countries got hit goals, right?
Yep.
What's another outcome that happened along the way? Something, a milestone along the way. Looking back from as if you just achieved it, what happened right before you just achieved it?
But should we start step four or just wait until you tell us?
We'll just listen to what she's doing for here.
Okay, so the goal is 500 subscriptions and in June. That's our first target.
So the target was achieved, was a 500, yep.
Okay. And you want another goal?
I want another outcome, a milestone, an event, significant event, a cool thing that happened. Let me just work with mine, for example. Mine's 6 months, so I'm working from April, from April backwards, and mine's an income goal. So basically I said, oh, well, one of the things that I did I achieved my income goal by the 1st of April, or the end of March. Well, what happened? Oh, you know, I got a referral to a new client for one of my $5,000 programs. And that came in February. Oh, and as a matter of fact, in February, I held a workshop on this stuff. You know, and I made $30,000 holding the workshop. Imagine that, I didn't know that, right? Well, so what happened? Oh, well, in December, I met somebody who really liked what I was doing and wanted to sponsor me to all of their, somebody I already know, right? I talked to my friend Carl, and he said, yes, I want you to work with all my clients, and I generated an extra couple of $1,000 a month doing that. So you're just making it up, okay? But they're milestones, they're outcomes. And again, okay, imagine that you've just completed your goal, it's fully accomplished just the way you want it, and you're looking backwards from today. What results? We're not talking about actions you took, we're talking about results that occurred. Okay?
So it's translated into three different languages.
There you go.
Besides English.
It's now, it was finished translated, right?
Absolutely.
Okay, so everybody got the idea of it? So just go back and you want to just put four or five different things that happened along the way. So you must have had a good return on an investment, or you met a new investment opportunity, or somebody gave you some money for something, or whatever, right? So can you, what happened for you, Catherine? You,
I purchased that scanner.
Right, but that was an action. So the result was
I got all of the things.
You got everything.
It worked perfectly.
It worked perfectly. Okay. And then you want to put a couple of milestones, outcomes or results, not actions. Okay. Just everybody give a shot at it. And again, do a bad job, that's perfectly fine. And I'm just trying to demonstrate the process to you. So far we haven't done any actions. We've just looked backwards and see what kind of results happened for us. Kind of different way of looking at it, right? Oh no. We got another hour. Anybody having trouble with this? Some help? Okay, just a couple of things that happened and you're making them up. It's not, you can't do it wrong because you're making it up. Everybody got some? Two or three? Who'd be willing to share an outcome that you have at some point along the way? So you say, like, my goal is an income goal, and my outcome is that, you know, my phone rang and somebody phoned me with business. Or my goal is a health goal, and my outcome is that I hit the milestone of a certain weight loss or body fat or whatever. Okay, well, let's share it out.
My goal is an income goal, and I'm interviewed on the Spark radio program.
Yes, perfect. Oh, nice outcome. Great. You guys got the idea? Somebody else? An outcome along the way?
No. My goal is actually competing in a bodybuilding contest. Reduce body fat from 15 to 9%.
Yeah. Right. And I think you got a date that you hit.
Yeah.
Good. Excellent. So you got the idea. Again, we're giving you the template here so you can go and work with it more deeply, right? Okay, so by the way, give those guys a hand for sharing. Thank you. And once we've got these outcomes, then what we do is we go to a completely different phase, and now we go, turn the page, to a timeline of actions, and instead of looking backwards, actions. And I think I'm just going to work with mine because it's 6 months and I've got it in my brain anyway. So I've got
So November, December, January, February, March. Oops, I did it backwards. Excuse me. Exactly what I don't want you to do. We start now here. We've got November, December, January. We're going to go the opposite way. February, March, April. And now I say, if I got those outcomes, what actions did I take? And we're going to start looking at what actions did I take in November. So I had a workshop in February, right? And I raised, you know, earned $30,000 from the workshop. So what had to happen in back in November, December for that to even be possible?
Designed the workshop.
I designed the workshop. Okay, so that's probably, I'm gonna say design here. Probably in January, so I got a better idea of it. What I, you know what? I probably did some speaking at VBN. That was an action, yeah? What else did I do? Oh, yeah. How do people find out about events? How do they make a decision? How do they make a decision to join? Sorry.
I apologize. They saw you on YouTube or something.
Yeah, but people don't generally sign up for events like this on YouTube. Where do they sign up? Generally, do an introduction evening. Yes.
Yes.
So that would be an action I would take, is to organize an introduction evening. It's probably going to be in Tyrol. There, right? Well, in order to organize an introduction evening and have it filled in January, what's going to have to happen?
Seed planting. In
December, what's going to happen in December?
Your trip.
I'm going to have to make a website, right? I haven't got one for it yet. For this particular product, right? So and then once I've got a website, then I can write some marketing letters. And then from that, I can lead that into my intro. Of course, there'd be other things, my, you know, my forms, my pricing, all that kind of stuff. But these are the broad strokes. I'm going to do, I'm going to do the website, marketing letters, that would lead to my intro, that goes into my workshop. Okay, good. So that's just one element of how I'm going to do it. There's other ways I'm going to generate revenue as well. I'm going to, you know, I think I need to go to more networking events. Like, for example, Board of Trade tomorrow morning, perhaps at 7 o'clock, right? See you there, right? So more networking so that I can get people to this intro. You guys understand what I'm doing here? So look at your goal and take it apart that way. What are some of the actions you need? What you'll find is that the things you need to do are closer to now, okay? So we looked backwards at the results you created. But now we're going to look forwards, and you're going to have most of the actions are going to be in the short term, because we don't really know. I don't really know what's going to happen with work. Oh, one of the things I had to do in November, book a room for the workshop. Yes, already got that done. So you make your list of things you're going to have to do here in order for it to all flow forward. So take a moment and get this, just jot some ideas down, actions you could take. And by the way, if this is completely twisting your brain, good. Because this is how to achieve goals, not all that other crap where you sat there and tried to get yourself into the right vibration and imagine the finished product instead of the actions. You know how you achieve a goal? Action. Nobody, whatever goal you wrote down, I don't care what it is, there's no way you're going to achieve any goal without taking a whole bunch of action. How do we know what action you're going to take? It's based on the outcomes that you're going to get. Well, okay, well, if in order to get that to happen, then these actions have to take place. And then along the way, you can continually modify it and change it in any way you want. So, I can change even my goal, or I can look at my goal and say, well, actually these things, when I look at the actions that have to be taken for me to get the kind of outcomes I want, I can't see how I can take those actions. I'm going to have to make some changes. So now you change this page to this page back and forth, and you just keep testing. Because here's what Philip taught me, that it's not that I didn't know it, but it wasn't so clear in my mind.
The only way you can fail to achieve a goal is to stop trying, is to quit. Every time you achieve a goal, any goal you ever achieve, you started doing stuff and it worked sometimes, but most of the time it didn't, right? So what did you do? You either quit or you kept going and found to try something else. And so it's this crooked path of fail, fail, fail. You know, you fail forward, and just the way to achieve a goal is to fail faster. And keep going and hold on to your goal. And so that's where these actions come in. You start getting specific actions and then you know, keep building, moving forward towards it. And 100% of the time, you will have failures and things that won't work and things that won't happen, and you'll go back and modify it. As long as you keep your goal on it and your eye on the goal and keep thinking, what are the outcomes that I see happening? Okay, what I see the outcomes that are happening? Okay, how am I going to, basically these are going to be the pieces that get me towards my goal. Then what are the actions that are going to lead to those outcomes? And just keep changing it. So I could say, I'm gonna speak to one event. Well, you know, I come here, nobody's interested in what I have to say. Okay, good. Well, then I go and speak somewhere else. Or maybe I decide speaking's not it for me and I start doing, I go and get some social media set up, or who knows what. It's just about holding onto the goal and continually taking action toward forward. Does this make sense? So I'm watching the time very carefully. My commitment here was that I would give you as much as I could in an hour. The intent was always from the beginning to show you a template. Okay, first of all of the stuff at the beginning, the goal you wrote, all the stuff about how it's impossible, and which was really just all this stuff, it starts to get diminished when you look at specific actions. Okay? So when you get specific about, oh, I'm going to do this, if it feels like you can't do it, just make it smaller and smaller and smaller actions, and you can do anything. You can achieve anything. It may be not on the timeline you want. You might have to adjust your goal, your timeline, or your activities. But you can achieve anything if you're willing to fail and fail and fail and fail and fail and fail and fail. Rather than, oh, I tried that, it didn't work. Oh, well, what's next? Again, this is what brings out the creativity. This is what finds you through. And this is what makes you unstoppable and achieve your goals when nobody else does. So at the bottom of the page there, the action planning says, once you've completed the above timelines, so again, you're going to draw the actions and put in your actions for the particular months you're going to do them, and that's going to guide you to do what needs to be done. And then once you've completed the above timelines, switch your attention to real-world actions. We're making them smaller now that you can take to identify, to achieve your goal. Small, specific steps you can take that in the near future that will advance you. And that's how, by the way, our coaching program has been as successful as it has. We've always had our clients make a quarterly plan, and then every single client in our program has always made a weekly action plan. What am I going to do this week to move ahead? It's what differentiates our program from everybody else's. This is taking it to a whole new level when we create a goal that is really significant and pulling us ahead. So I promised Roger I'd be willing to take some questions. So now it's over to you for a moment. And what are you seeing in this? What observations do you have, comments do you have, or questions? So, yeah.
What happens when week over week people don't achieve their weekly action goals?
What do you think? Anyone?
Nothing.
Well, first of all, nothing happens. You're right about that. No movement happens. But so here's what I say to my clients. If you set the same goal, action goal, twice in a row, 2 weeks in a row, and you don't achieve it, on the third week, cut it in half. It's obviously too big, right? Or it's not make it smaller. So instead of getting your income tax done, spend 5 minutes on it. And see what happens. You break the surface tension, you get started on it. So that answers your question? And basically, if a person doesn't take action, they're not going to get any result. But the chances are what it really means is you need to modify your actions. You're not, you haven't got the right actions. Yeah, question?
Two questions. Number one, what I do is depending on what the goal is, I basically say I'm going to spend only half an hour on this, and that's okay. After this, if I don't get it done, I won't feel guilty. I'll come back tomorrow.
Yes.
Now, question number two I have for you is...
And then the only question is, as long as that's going to get you to your goal on time, that's good.
Exactly. Question number two I have for you is, when I achieve certain goals like buying a house and et cetera, I feel guilty. There are certain individuals, when I go on these tastings and I'm thinking, what can I do so they can be in a similar place? So I don't know, maybe it's their childhood memories or bad memories, whatever, growing up. So I'm not sure how to overcome that. I want others to have it as well.
Well, you're bringing it to a subject which is completely within my expertise but beyond the scope of this presentation. So I can actually change your beliefs. And if you want to talk to me about that later, I'd be happy to tell you how we can do that. Lynn's smiling because she can do it too. And but yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
But so we did that guilt is part of what's holding you back, right?
Yeah. Right. Well, so I achieved certain goals, but I want the others to have it as well, and I'm not sure exactly what I can do.
Well, there's a philosophical and a practical element to it that's beyond the scope of this conversation.
Right, yeah.
But for sure, my only concern is it's blocking you from achieving more, and the more you achieve, the more you can give. So it's preventing you, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I'd like to hear from one person. Well, let me just ask this. We'll do it as a general. How many of you feel more optimistic that you can really achieve this goal? Yeah. If you follow this process and compete, you keep going back through it, you can change your goal achievement experience, you can change your outcomes, change your actions, keep modifying it, and you look at it for 15 minutes a day or an hour a week or something, you will achieve that goal. You'll be just stunned by it. So it's really quite amazing. So in terms of what's next, just to wrap up here, in a moment I'm going to give you a handout. It's going to have four items on it for you to choose from. So the first one is a gift. How many want a gift? I thought you might, so I brought one for you. In our coaching program, there are certain principles that we teach our clients that are designed to help them grow their businesses and move things forward faster. And one of the ones that can make the biggest difference the fastest is called how to develop your centers of influence. It's kind of like what Roger was talking about in terms of getting the ask for the right person, right? When you can build relationship with the right person, you can go a lot further. So, and how to utilize and leverage the centers of influence that you don't even know you have now. So that's what this is all about. So it's a powerful little book. Our clients work on it all the time. This is really only for the members of our program. I put a $97 value on this. But I've got one of you. All you've got to do is give us your information. We'll send you one of these. This is printed off an electronic version exactly like I'll send you. Fair enough? So that's my gift to you, because I didn't want to sponsor the food today. Okay, second thing.
So you want people's business cards? So
we can actually pass these out. The second thing I have for you is the Pro Coach system. I talked about my coaching program. We've been doing it for 16 years, 5,000 people have done it. The results are consistent, they're extraordinary. If you're interested in knowing more about that program, just check the box and I'll follow up with you and answer any questions you have. That would be fine. The third thing is, as I mentioned, I'm going to be doing a two-day workshop that's going to go in full detail. And the biggest missing piece that we didn't have time for is how you remove all of these holdbacks. And much as I would have liked to give you everything today, I just couldn't. So that two-day workshop, I'm going to be doing some introductions. If you're interested in knowing more about that, if you check the box, I'll make sure you get invited to the introductions. And the last thing I'll say is that for anybody who feels like, I don't know what it is about that guy, but I'd be interested in knowing more about what he does, or maybe he's a guy that I want to work with, the very best way to get a sense of me and what I do that's really valuable for you is to come to our Pro Coach headquarters in North Vancouver, meet with me for 2 hours. You're going to pay $500 for a strategic planning session. Now, if your business hasn't got the possibility to generate $500 extra in some strategic planning, probably not time. But if you can see that you can get $500 worth from some good strategy, then you can book one of those sessions, come to me, well, there's a preparation sheet, we sit down, and money back guarantee, I guarantee the money's there. You'll be very, very delighted with it, and you'll really know whether I have something to offer or not. Now, Roger twisted my arm on this, and glad he did. So because of this particular group and my relationship with Roger, I'm going to discount that $500 package. You can take your pen and cross it out and write $200 right in there. So $200 for 2 hours with me, and we haven't had time to even touch the infinitesimal part of what I know about how to make your business go and support you to become the person you need to become. So if you want to have a session like that, I'd be delighted to have it, and you'll get to know me, and you'll leave with value, or you'll get your money back. So with that, it's a sophisticated process to go back to the goal setting. Just play with it, work with it. Come to the introductions. I'm not even sure what I'm going to do in them, but you'll get some more value. You don't have to do the workshop. If it calls to you, then talk to me about the workshop, and we'll get into that. But for me now, I just want to say thank you for the opportunity. Was that more fun than a talk? Yeah? How many of you got some value? Excellent. Go and achieve those goals, and when you do, please let me know. I was at your goal setting workshop at VBN, and guess what? I just achieved my goal. That's what I live for, is to see my clients be successful. So thank you very much for the opportunity to give you and share this information that I've got, and I wish you all the best. I'll hang around for a little bit if anybody wants to talk to me, and thank you, Roger, for the opportunity.
Thank you.